When you're locked down, stuck down, your head is heading downtown. Don't despair if you think you're getting nowhere. Try, try, and try, then your courage will multiply. When you have a go, when you get into the flow, yeah.
We light our candle, we will read our Holy Trinity prayer. Love of Jesus, fill us. Holy Spirit, guide us. Will of the Father be done. Amen.
This week is Anti-Bullying Week.
But to be honest, every week is Anti-Bullying Week. But what is bullying?
We have these posters around school to help identify what it is. You see, sometimes someone says or does something unintentionally hurtful, and that's rude if they do it once. Sometimes people are mean. That's when someone says or does something intentionally hurtful, and they do it once. That's mean. But when someone says or does something intentionally hurtful, and they keep doing it, even when you tell them to stop or show them you're upset, that's bullying.
Okay, I'm going to share some scenarios with you now. And you need to decide whether it's an example of rudeness, meanness, or bullying. Here's the first one. There we go. Rosie tells Matthew that she can't sit with her at dinner today because she is saving the seat for a girl in another class. Is that rude? Mean, or is it bullying? Have a think. Rude, mean, bullying, 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 rude. Rosie is being rude. There's no evidence of intentional meanness, repeated behaviour, or a power imbalance. All right, next location. Come with me. There's one. Says, Liam tells Damien that he can't play with the Lego because he's the worst builder in the whole school. Rude, mean, or bullying? Have a think. Rude, mean, bullying, 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 rude, mean. Liam is being mean. It appears that the words are intended to hurt Damien, but there's no evidence of repeated behaviour or a power imbalance. Okay, moving on. Here we go. There's one. Okay, let's have a read. Tia makes plans to go to the school disco with her new friend, Gwen. Katie tells Tia that if she hangs out at the disco with Gwen, that everyone will think she's a total weirdo and no one will like her anymore. At lunch that day, Katie convinces everyone that it would be a really funny joke to all laugh out loud when Tia approached the lunch table. Is that rude, mean, or is it bullying? Have a think.
Rude, mean, bullying, rude, mean, bullying, rude, mean, bullying, rude, mean, bullying, rude.
Katie's acting like a bully. She's creating an unfair balance of power by getting all the girls at the lunch table to laugh at Tia. She's also using words like everyone and no one to threaten Tia about how she will be socially excluded if she doesn't not do what Katie wants her to do. That's an imbalance of power. That's bullying. Moving on. Nothing else. This one's right in my room. There we are. There we go. Here's the next scenario. Devin and David are friends. In school, they had an argument. Devin called David a name, and David shoved him out of his way. Is that rude? Is it mean, or is it bullying? Have a think.
Rude, mean, bullying, 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 rude.
David and Devin are engaging in rough play, or rude behaviour. This is not bullying because the boys are usually friends, and the power balance is relatively equal, and the boys are not intending to harm each other. Found another one. Here we are. Can we see that? Maggie is making fun of the fact that Jesse hangs out with the boys at playtime and wears long shorts to school every day. In PE, Maggie told her to go play on the boys' team, and the day before she teased Jessie about her name being a boy's name too. Is that rude, mean, or bullying? Have a think. No more spinning, I'm getting dizzy. Maggie's acting like a bully. She's making fun of Jessie repeatedly, with intention to cause harm. This kind of behaviour will be taken seriously in school. Yes, there's one. You see that one? Bradley told Jake he would beat him up if he touched his cars, then shoved Jake out of his way. During math class, he threw a rubber at Jake and kicked his chair out from under him. He threatened to punch Jake if Jake told the teacher. Is that rude, mean, or is it bullying? Have a think. Bradley is acting like a bully. He's engaged in repetitively cruel behaviour and it's designed to hurt Jake. He's using intimidation and threats to create a power imbalance. That's bullying. I found another one underneath a chair. We see that one. Okay. Ellie and Fiona play on the same hockey team and are normally best friends, but have been in an argument for 3 days. Ellie called Fiona a mean name after practice, and Fiona sent Ellie a mean text. Is that rude, mean, or is it bullying? Have a think. Oops. Who puts things under chairs? Ellie and Fiona are being mean to each other. They're intending to hurt each other with their words and their texts. The girls are normally friends, though, and at this point, this appears to be a mutual argument rather than a repetitive pattern of one-sided cruelty. So at the minute, they're being mean to each other. Neck of the door. There's one. I'll bring the camera close so you can read it. Jessica likes to be first in the line and always rushes to the front. sometimes pushing or barging over children to get there.
Is that rude, mean, or is it bullying?
Have a think.
No, no more spinning. No, Jessica is being mean. Her behaviour isn't directed at anyone in particular. And she just hasn't learned to share or think about other people's feelings yet.
It's important that we're able to recognise behaviour. Because by being able to recognise behaviour, we know how to handle it.
We all do things that we regret sometimes. Sometimes through carelessness and sometimes through silliness. But it's best to admit our errors and accept the consequences. The hopeful thing is that failure doesn't have to be the last word. Christians believe that God forgives us, forgives the wrong and careless things we do when we are truly sorry. They believe that he helps us to change our ways. We can make up for the things that we do wrong by becoming better people. After Jesus was taken prisoner, Peter, who was one of Jesus' best friends, swore that he didn't know Jesus. Later, he was ashamed of his denial of Jesus. He accepted his failure and cried to Jesus for help. He was restored and became a leader of the early church.
It's important to talk if you are experiencing problems. And of course, if someone is being rude or mean, bullying, or if you've ever got any concerns or any problems, you've always got lots of adults in school that you can talk to. All the adults in school are trained to be able to listen to you.
Putting my socks on.
But more specifically, I'm putting odd socks on.
The idea behind wearing odd socks is that as we are all different, we can still work together and be unique. Check out these wonderful odd socks. We're all different and unique. And so too is the animal world.
In that short video, everything had spots, but all the spots were different and unique, and that's great.
When you look around your classroom, the playground, or even your family, does everyone look the same? You're right, they don't. There are so many things about us that make us different and unique. Think about all the things that make you and others unique and special. But remember, not all of these things are things we can see. Likely people we know have different skin color, different hair color and texture, or different eye color. They may be in a wheelchair or have some other physical disability. Perhaps they don't think or learn the way you do. Maybe they have two moms or two dads, or maybe their family is religious. We all eat different kinds of food and wear different kinds of clothes. Some of us even speak different languages. There is so much more, and it's all very cool. Life would be pretty boring if we were all exactly the same, wouldn't it? You might think that these differences mean we can't understand one another, but that's not true. Even though we have all of these amazing differences that make us unique and beautiful, there is also so much about us that is similar. All of us, regardless of background or life situation or experience, have a lot in common. And one of the most important things is that we all have feelings. We all get worried and scared. We all get sad and cry. We all get frustrated and even angry. And we also all experience happiness and laugh. Perhaps most importantly, we all have a deep desire to be cared about and accepted for exactly who we are. The best thing we can do when we meet someone that seems different from us is remember that we are probably a lot more similar than we think. It's pretty awesome, and sometimes even surprising, how many similarities we find once we really get to know someone. Think about something unique about yourself that makes you different from others, and what you most love about that difference. And if you are so inclined, share it with others without any apology at all.
For those of you who've seen Walt Disney's Bambi, you may remember something that Thumper said.
If you can't say something nice, don't say nothing at all.
So I'm tasking you today, children, to call it out with kindness. Which means, in your free time, I want you to find someone and say something nice to someone. You could say, I like your socks. You could say, I'm glad you're here today. You could say, you're fun to be with. But the task is that simple, children. Find someone and say something nice to them.
Time for a prayer. And if you'd like this prayer to be your prayer at time at the end, you're welcome to look at the candle flame, or you can put your hands in your eyes together. Dear Lord, help us to use our words for kindness. Amen.
And remember, children, if you're ever worried or concerned about anything, you have got lots of adults in school that you can talk to. Any of the adults. We are all here to listen. And we're all here to help. Well, that concludes our collective worship for today. Remember, work hard, be kind, look after yourselves. And your task today is to call it out with kindness. Find someone and say something nice to them. And I'll see you around school.
When you're locked down, stuck down, your head is heading downtown.